Thank you, Ricardo. I only can reiterate how much it is a pleasure to be on a physical conference again, right? So this is the first time I'm on a conference. I have the honor to speak, so thank you very much for the invite. Thank you much for having me. And I was asked to give a small keynote for the introduction into today's conference and into the panels. And when I thought about it, we are on the Asia Berlin Summit. What came to my mind is actually how much the world has become smaller. We all know that through the last 20, 30 years, capital, goods, digital information, everything is flowing between the East and the West, and it became one world, it became a small world. There's way more travel and going on. And so until Corona was hitting us, this has become a really small world, right? And how everything now also physically is separated or feels separated, how goods now take longer. We see that in the supply chain. This is the one thing where we find out, okay, the world perhaps is really not so small as we thought, right? And the second thing I want to come to in this keynote is look at digital ecosystems. So while this all happened, when digital ecosystems evolved, we again had a split between Eastern and Western digital ecosystems. So related to, we all know, political developments, but also different customer behavior and different customer preferences, we have seen very different platforms emerging and getting a lot of adoption in the West. We all know the GAFAs, Google, Amazon, etc. And we know that in Asia, there is like WeChat is very strong, for example. We know that Alibaba is the local Amazon. And all of these stronger movements into these ecosystems have rather separated the digital ecosystems throughout the last years. And this is obviously something we need to recognize when we talk about how do these how do we in our ecosystem, in the blockchain community, communicate with each other. And while all of these digital ecosystems are now fomenting themselves and even like more separating themselves, we are in a certain niche, blockchain-related, crypto-related, startup ecosystem. That is a typical niche area in which we rather go deeper into information. We search for very specific topics, very specific conversations. We want to know very edgy topics and very recent developments, right? And so the information asymmetry we are witnessing is even deeper in our community than it perhaps is on a rather political or more global information level. Like if there's warships in the South Asian Sea, you will see that in the TV, even with like these split ecosystems. But if there is like certain discussions about really edgy new crypto startups, this is going on either in Telegram or in WeChat. And then what happens to this information? Is it accessible? Do you really, if you are going into this ecosystem and want to gather information, do you really see the full picture? And so why does this specifically bother me, or why do I bring this up in terms of our blockchain ecosystem? I think there's three very unique characteristics which I want to point out in relation to these separated digital ecosystems. First of all, the thing we talk about today, blockchain, by nature, is cross-border, internationally, globally. There are no borders. It is one ecosystem, and it's not split into these different silos. And so when we want to invest, when we want to use it, when we take it as an underlying technology, as a protocol layer, it's by nature everywhere accessible at the same time. And so it's even more important to have a universal understanding and conversation and information about this topic than even in other areas. The second topic, which makes for me the blockchain ecosystem unique in that regard, is that innovation happens even faster in this space than in other areas. So you hear that a lot of times. I think one crypto year is five normal startup years, and come on, we have seen that again, like after cryptocurrencies, now we have seen with NFTs again, how unbelievable fast adoption is spreading, also again, because it's so so universal, it's so worldwide, it doesn't know borders. And so it's not only how fast innovation is happening, it's also how much it gets relevance, a lot of relevance, monetary-wise, but also then back into other economic areas. So this is a second characteristic why I would say it's even more important that you are really worldwide well-informed about what's going on. And the third angle, obviously, is if you are an investor, if you are a blockchain enthusiast, if you're a startup, you want to be on the pulse of time, right? You want to really know the most recent developments. Just a good example, how long did it take until I personally, and I consider myself very interested, I'm super deep in, for example, crypto Twitter, and how long it took until I knew what Axie Infinity is. I think the Yield Guild, which is basically building on Axie Infinity, was already a huge thing when I heard the first time about it at all. So this is one of these examples. And so what does that mean? If I'm an investor, I have the need to find out, if I'm talking to a startup, is there perhaps somewhere else in the world something which has perhaps the same product, right? Is this unique? Or is something else somewhere else emerging and even gets more adoption and more traction than the thing I'm currently looking at? Also, from another angle, if I look into an investment target, I want to know, is it trustworthy? Is it reliable? And I want to gather information around it. So if, you know, it plays a huge role, where can I gather my information around it? And if I'm not in the right digital ecosystem, do I really then have the right access to information? On the other hand, if you're a startup, looking from the other direction, you also want to see, do I have a competitive edge? Or is there perhaps somewhere else in the world somebody doing the same thing and is my potential competitor and I even don't know it? So these are the characteristics why I think that for the blockchain ecosystem, it's even more important to get out of your information silo and cross in worldwide and build bridges to get information and to gather information about what's happening and to connect yourself. And that is why this is a great event. That is why I'm happy that we are invited and we can take part in a platform in which we can make these connections, we can build these bridges. So I wish every one of us and all of you a really good conference today. Try to reach out to people, try to build connections, connect via whatever platform you want to follow up on this and get the most out of it. Thank you.